Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Heading through the day today, of course, we ended up with a bit of a messy afternoon and a messy start to the evening as well. But look at this start to the day that we had from Freeport at Wolf's Neck. We had a gorgeous sunrise out there this morning before the clouds took over and before that precipitation took over as well. So here's a time lapse showing those clouds filling in, and then there's the raindrops on the webcam, the rain taking over along the coast, whereas to further inland, we did pick up few inches of snowfall. Looking at the temperatures heading overnight into early Sunday, we drop back below freezing for many spots. So something to watch out for is going to be the development of black ice as we head through the night tonight, just due to those wet surfaces from today refreezing as these temperatures drop. So that's something you want to watch out for if you're traveling tonight or early tomorrow. Also, areas of patchy fog out there this evening may make for some reduced visibility as well. Sunday, though, is going to overall be a pretty decent day. We do start brighter and then the clouds build in through the afternoon. But look at these temperatures. We again climb into the 40s for highs on Sunday. So it's going to be another mild day. However, by Sunday night into Monday, we're looking at our next chance for precipitation. And it does look like we see rain showers along the coast, but of course the mountains could be looking at some snow showers from this. It does look very light, however, so this is what we're expecting with that storm tracker. Sunday, a mainly dry day. Notice those clouds building in through the afternoon, and then here comes those showers later Sunday night. By the time 10, 11 o'clock rolls around, we'll start to see those showers pushing into western parts of Maine, some snow showers possible in the mountains, and we're keep an eye on where this mixing line is here. But I do think that this is all going to be fairly light, and it's going to be very quick, too. Here we go, 7, 8 a.m. Monday. This is already starting to move out, and by mid-morning, this is already pushing east of our area. And we're going to be left with mainly dry conditions as we head through Monday afternoon. Now, Monday night, we're going to see a sharp cold front across the region. That could trigger a few snow showers or even a few snow squalls. So that'll be something to watch out for if you're traveling late Monday night. But otherwise, Tuesday will be dry, but it will be very cold and windy. A big difference between Monday and Tuesday temperature-wise. Monday's highs are climbing into the upper 40s, and Tuesday we struggle to get out of the 20s. So 20-degree difference there between those 2 days, and then we warm up again Wednesday. So just keep that in mind, that while these next couple of days may feel more spring-like, it's not going to be that way by the time we hit Tuesday.